Imagine this, a Tesla with no one in the driver's seat, cruising down the streets of Austin, Texas, right now. The robo-taxi revolution isn't coming, it's already here. Hey everyone, it's Ken. If you're a Tesla investor, owner, or just someone fascinated by the future of mobility, you're in the right place. Today's video covers the latest breakthrough in Tesla's full self-driving tech and a bold new challenge Elon Musk is facing from investors. Let's dive in. On June 12th, Tesla is expected to officially launch its robo-taxi service in Austin. But here's the kicker, it's already in motion. Over the past few days, fully driverless Model Ys have been seen navigating public roads with zero human intervention. That's right, no safety driver, no remote control, just AI. Even more impressive, this testing phase started an entire month ahead of schedule, and Tesla isn't stopping there. The next phase, cars that deliver themselves from the factory straight to your driveway. That's not a sci-fi dream anymore. It's about to become reality. What powers this? A software called FSD, Unsupervised, short for Full Self-Driving Without Supervision. In simple terms, no driver, no monitor, no one watching. The car makes every driving decision all on its own. Now let's talk about the robo-taxi launch itself. Multiple media outlets are reporting that Tesla is preparing to kick off its Austin-based service with around 10 to 20 Model Ys. But this won't be a full public rollout, not yet. At first, the service will be invite-only, targeting a select group of users. This gradual approach allows Tesla to fine-tune safety, gather feedback, and secure regulatory approval. It's a smart, cautious move, and it shows just how seriously Tesla is taking this launch. Now, while Tesla's robo-taxi efforts are surging ahead, there's a very different kind of development unfolding behind the scenes. Investors are putting serious pressure on Elon Musk. According to recent reports, a coalition of 12 major institutional investors, including pension funds in the US and Europe, have sent a letter to Tesla's board of directors. Their demand? That Elon Musk be contractually obligated to dedicate at least 40 hours per week to Tesla. Why the concern? Because Elon isn't just leading Tesla, he's also juggling roles at X, formerly Twitter, SpaceX, Neuralink, The Boring Company, and more. These investors believe his attention is spread too thin, and that Tesla's performance is suffering as a result, and the numbers add weight to their argument. In the first quarter of 2025, Tesla's revenue reportedly dropped 13% year over year, and net income fell by 71%. Since its peak in December 2024, the stock has slid nearly 24%. With that backdrop, investors are starting to ask tough questions about Elon's leadership, and some are even calling for a change in CEO if he can't focus more on Tesla. The letter also urges the board to limit Elon's influence and move toward a more independent governance structure, shifting away from a one-man, charismatic leadership style. In other words, it's time to go from Elon-powered to governance-driven. So how is Elon responding? Well, he just announced that he's stepping down from his role in DOGE, the US government's internal task force aimed at improving efficiency. He gave two reasons. First, he completed the legally capped 130-day term for special government employees. Second, he expressed disappointment in a new budget bill proposed by Donald Trump called the One Big Beautiful Bill. Elon believes the bill would actually increase the federal deficit, which goes against DOGE's original mission to reduce government waste. Many see this as a sign that Elon wants to refocus on private sector innovation, where he has more control and more impact. It could also signal that he's clearing his schedule to spend more time on Tesla. So, what does all of this mean for us, Tesla owners and shareholders? For owners, the robotaxi and self-delivery tests signal that your Tesla vehicle could soon become a revenue-generating asset. Imagine your car giving people rides while you sleep and earning money for you. and for investors. This is another clear sign that Tesla is evolving into more than just a car company. It's becoming a mobility and AI platform, where cars not only drive themselves, but also generate recurring income through services. A whole new business model is taking shape. But let's not ignore the risks. The Robotaxi rollout still faces regulatory hurdles, social acceptance, and technical challenges. And Elon's political positions and public statements will continue to influence Tesla's brand and stock, sometimes in unpredictable ways. Today's episode covered Tesla's Robotaxi launch, investor pushback against Elon Musk, and his exit from DOGE. All of these moves could shape the future of Tesla and how it's led. So let me ask you, what do you think about the Robotaxi rollout? Should Elon spend less time on X and more time at Tesla? Drop your thoughts in the comments. I'd love to hear them. As of recording this video, Tesla stock is climbing, currently at $361. Some analysts are speculating that Elon's DOGE exit is restoring investor confidence. If you found this video helpful or insightful, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel. I post Tesla updates every single day, so if you want to stay ahead of the curve, hit that subscribe button now. Thanks for watching, and as always, enjoy life with Tesla.